I am Kathleen Brown, celebrating my 50th year in nursing. My story is about the middle of my career, my 20 years as a women's health nurse practitioner working in an office with three obstetrician gynecologists. Many of our patients are memorable, but I want to tell you about one particular woman. We met during an evening office session with me as the only provider. I had three support staff working with me that evening. While moving from one examination room to another, I saw a woman standing in the waiting room. This is very unusual. People always sit. I'd never seen standing and waiting before. She's a beautiful woman with lovely dark hair cut expertly into a bob, and she's wearing an eye-catching, very pretty suit. She was also overweight. Weight to the point none of our waiting room chairs could accommodate her girth. Her pretty face looked anxious, but that's not at all unusual. When you make an appointment with someone new, it creates anxiety in absolutely anybody. I completed an exam, then approached my new patient. My routine was taking each new patient to my office for an introductory chat, but I could not in this case because my office chairs are the same as the waiting room chairs. I took my patient directly to an examination room. After I closed the door, I heard staff giggling. I assume about my new patient. If I heard it, she did also. My first thought was, this is not okay. Followed by a quick thought of, what do I do now? Racing through my head was the idea that she had been hearing giggling or worse from many other people in her life. What should I say and do? What would she like me to say and do? I believe I felt just as anxious as she was at that point in time. This patient was knocking on a door I had never opened. She was knocking on a door that required skills I feared I did not have. What came to mind along with the fear was a realization that I had to relieve her anxiety and mine and start building trust. If I fail, this visit will fail, and I would never see this patient again. I wouldn't be nursing helpful, and I must be nursing helpful. Suddenly, crashing into all my worries and doubts was an answer. Treat her as you treat any patient. Treat her with respect and kindness. Actively listen and be your compassionate nursing self. The exam table was our first barrier. I feared if this patient sat on the tail end of the table, the head end would rise up from the floor. She could slip, and the table head might hit her head. So I told her about my fear and explained a need for me to lie across the top of the table as a counterweight. She smiled at my description of the potential problem plus proposed solution. And from there, we developed a "we are in this together" mode, led by her comedic description of what was happening. Together, we fine-tooled the plan, and now the giggling was ours. Our method worked, and she was safely seated at last with both of us smiling. I sat on my stool, moved closer to her with new confidence. Now seated, my new patient revealed she made this appointment to discuss contraception. That's a very comfortable topic for me. I presented options. She chose one. I did a brief exam, noting she had elevated blood pressure. During this first visit, I noticed that she has a great sense of humor. She has excellent verbal skills and large affection for her partner. Her face absolutely lit up when she was talking about him. One of the things she said about him is, he understands. He understands was said in a way that I should understand what she meant, but I did not. I filed the phrase away in my head and held it until our next meeting. She left with a referral for further investigation of her elevated blood pressure and an appointment to return to my office in 2 months for a check on how the contraceptive method she had chosen was working. In 2 months, she returned with her partner. He's a slight man, short in stature, and light in weight. "He understands" became clearer. Perhaps he too had experienced giggling, and worse, about his short stature and weight. The outstanding feature I noticed about him was that he had a huge smile that went all the way up into his eyes. His smile encourages a smile from anyone who sees it. During this second visit, my patient revealed her contraceptive method was working well for both of them. They were pleased. They had a few questions that were easy to answer, and their affection for each other was very apparent and a pleasure to witness. A couple years later, this lovely patient made an appointment to discuss pregnancy. Both she and her partner felt they were ready for a baby. For the sake of her health, I recommended weight loss before pregnancy in order to reduce the physical risks to her. Simply put, becoming pregnant would be less risky if she weighed less. With lots of encouragement from her partner and her family, she lost all the excess weight in less than 2 years. My small contribution was encouraging her on the telephone on occasion. Her partner and her parents did all the work of assisting. After the weight loss, she became pregnant. I had the pleasure of providing prenatal care. Her pregnancy was uneventful. She delivered a healthy baby girl with no complications. Mom and baby went home safe and healthy. There were several more visits with this delightful woman before I left my practice. Her husband remained affable and his smile remained contagious. Her sense of humor became more pronounced, which was helpful in caring for a new baby, as anyone who's brought home a new baby knows. One patient out of many changed my office routine, prompted a change in furniture. Support staff learned how to giggle with our patients, not behind closed doors. This woman also changed my level of understanding about weight and weight loss. And perhaps most importantly, she changed my use of words. She enhanced the attention I pay to what I say and how I say it. The patient in this story helped me be a better nurse, and I believe a better person.